Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Flame Learning Channel. In the previous video, you performed a 3D track using a media mat as an exclusive constraint. This allowed you to track a camera move within a shot, but ignore any foreground distractions that could compromise the track. In part 2 of this 3-part series, we'll tackle the same shot again. But this time, we'll use a Gmask shape as the exclusive constraint. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your web browser. Before we start, I need to mention that this media was shot by Dizzy Films and downloaded from mazwy.com. This is licensed under the Creative Commons 3.0 licensing scheme, so please respect the licensing guidelines. As a reminder, this shot is 120 frames, so please set the batch duration accordingly. So the end goal is the same as part 1. We need to perform a 3D track on this shot. However, this time, there is no media mat provided. So you could spend time crafting a mat. But this time, you will simply create a Gmask shape, track it to the glider, and then use it as an exclusive constraint for 3D tracking. So in batch, use a fresh action and connect the source clip into the background input. Also select the action node and press Ctrl+N for a new media input. Just connect the source clip into the red front input. Now call up the action controls and switch to a dual screen split. Turn off the background input using the pull-down menu. Next, delete the image object and the axis, as the 3D tracking will recreate the surface object with a 3D tracked camera. Now it's important to note that you need to set up the 3D tracking nodes first before creating any Gmask shapes. If you create the Gmask shape first and then link it to the 3D track, the shape will slide because it won't be in sync with the 3D tracking camera. Please do not forget this important point. So ensure you are in the action node bin and select the media assigned to input 1. In the node bin, drag out an analyzer mono node into the result viewer. This switches the view to analyzer viewer for the 3D track. This view is also mapped to F7 as a keyboard shortcut. Now that the nodes are set up, you can now create a Gmask shape and track it. Select the image object at the bottom of the flow graph. In the action node bin, drag out a Gmask and it will attach itself to the selected image object. In the analyzer viewer, go ahead and draw a Gmask shape around the glider. Ensure you close the shape when it's complete. Next, you'll track this to the glider. There are multiple ways of doing this, but we'll keep this part simple. Double-click on the axis for the object controls. Switch the object menu to the tracking options. We'll use a point tracker for this, so click Enter Tracker. Now position the tracker box at the top of the glider. That should be fine, and you can press Analyze to start the track. That works relatively quick, and it should be accurate enough. Now click Return to exit the tracker. If you scrub the time bar, you will note that the Gmask shape has shifted off the glider because of the tracking offset. To reposition the Gmask over the glider, switch to the Axis menu. On frame 1, click the Adjust Offset button. When you scrub the time bar, the mask will stick to the glider and cover it. That should be fine for what you need. Next, go to the action schematic and double-click on the Analyzer Mono node. Set the camera settings to Free 3D Motion. Set the tracker size to 10 and the number of trackers to 200. Now when you look at the constraints header, you will notice that Ignore Mat is grayed out. This is due to the fact that you are not using a media mat this time. However, Track Outside Shape is now enabled. So you can choose to track inside or outside the Gmask shape. This is because the Gmask shape is part of the Analyzer Mono flow graph and is connected to the image object. The Gmask shape would not be available or work properly if you did not set it up this way. So you are going to track outside the shape. Press Analyze. The 3D track begins the analysis, and once the work is done, it will begin to solve the 3D camera. When the track completes, you should see the point cloud. If you only see the blue tracker boxes or nothing at all, toggle the F7 keyboard shortcut to toggle the analyzer viewer. Scrubbing the time bar, you will see that the glider is completely ignored by the 3D tracker as a result of using the Gmask shape as an exclusive constraint. You now have an accurate 3D track, and you could begin compositing and finishing the shot. So remember that if you have a media mat, you will use the workflow outlined in part 1. But if you don't have a media mat and use a Gmask instead, use this workflow. And remember to set up the Analyzer Mono nodes first before creating the Gmask shape, and you should be fine. In the final part of using exclusive constraints with tracking, we'll cover the workflow of setting up exclusive constraints with planar tracking. The setup is slightly different to 3D tracking, so this is definitely something you should not miss. See you in the next video. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please remember to subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.